I make sketches on my note. I take a stylus over there, make pen, sketch over there, mail it. Send to my office. Again, form a note and they send back to me, make correction on that, send it back to them. People have become more oral architects. They speak architecture. They don't draw architecture. They don't design architecture. They comment architecture. They philosophy in architecture. But they can't do architecture. There's no shortcut. An architect, there's no shortcut. You have to draw with your hand. The fastest way is your head and hand. Whether you put draw on the paper or you draw on the computer, it's here and here. The more you do here, the better practice you have. I'm always very hungry about something new. New technology, new trends, new equipment, new camera, new phone, new watch. New something new gadgets, you will call them over there. New car, new this thing, you know, keep on trying something different. So I will try to remain ahead, trying to use technology, new trend, new thing over there. So computer was something for me fascinating. I was the first one to buy a computer in the country, first architect to buy a computer in the country. I spent 5 lakh rupees in about 86, 286 model, such a big box came over there. Couldn't draw bloody's line and whole day, couldn't draw bloody one room. And then, you know, they printed the plotter, such a huge thing over there. And air conditioned room, dust-free environment, whatnot. And my office boys, they said, hey, kya hai, dabba sahab, this thing is not going to work. And nobody wanted to learn. I had a tutor come in specially for them to give tuition classes in my office over here. You know, and I'm paying, I'm saying, no, one day going to work. It took me 5 years. 5 years, then technology changed, they came over there, then started coming to the colleges, the people started learning colleges. The students who came, new one, they were willing to adopt to these computers, not the old staff. Gradually old staff started coming to that. All my buildings are clean, simple, but lack of for acrobatics. But as an architect, my job, how a human will use it, functional part of concern, get experience on that. Simple and functional. My design philosophy is based on simply functional design. That's my philosophy. In my thinking, design has got three elements. One is appeal. Very first thing, appeal. You see something, looks good. Second thing is drama. Does your drama not form, color, tone, texture? You know, it has drama in that. That's what the architect does over there. Third is function. Does it function? It should function very, very simply. You may have a lot of technology in that. You may have a lot of difficult system in that over there. When it comes to functional part, it should function like a simple handphone. Your smartphone functions very quickly. A layman can use it. Milkman can use it. Vendor can use it, key guy can use it, newspaper can use it, even Kisan can use it. That's called simplicity of function. And so architect is something, is a way of arrangement doing things. Way of manipulating, way of having things done, way of organizing it. This self-oriented architecture, it works on that. The architecture, the PC architecture, an architect is trained to learn many things. Science, art, technology, economics, philosophies, and vision, and think beyond. Architect is supposed to be leader, the designer. Architect is supposed to guide. Architect is supposed to acquire his knowledge, enhance his knowledge. His philosophical, he can dream. Years back, did you ever think about the color light changing? This idiot wants color light changing his house. So I said, an electrical fellow who doesn't understand lighting, but he knows something. I said, lighting, okay, light dim ho jata hai, light, but the color change hota hai, haan hota hai. Thoda isko adjust karega, to kuch farak padega. Will make some change. Slightly adjusted here and there. Local electrician, even a slightly intelligent guy, I think, sir, it will make some difference over there. We tried it here. It's a, by changing resistance over there, the light color change, center resistance over there. Boss, we want to make color wheel of this. Actually, 3-4 light color differently. Sir, gumaega isko, isko thoda turn karega isko. Slight turn this around over here and change the light. Turn a little more over here, change the light. Turn a little more over here, change the light. So become 3 colors, 4 colors. I put my house with light dimmer box, light box. Now I'm experimenting it. Later on, this is available. Then become automated later on. The manual. So this is architects. That means many people before us and our people in future, they've been doing it. Then how you devise it? Because you learn how behavior of a structure you learn after doing it. It's simply applying your knowledge and trying to understand how the behavior comes. We are trained to do that. We are visualized to do that. See, people keep on asking about sustainable architecture. They talk about green architecture. You know, these things have come as some magic mantra, almost everybody talking about these days. I'm an old timer. I belong to last century. As an architect, we architects, we've been doing green architecture or sustainable architecture part of our life, and any architect is supposed to do it. All our old buildings done in Bombay had high roofs, they had big verandas, they had ventilators, they had cross ventilation as part of norms, planning norms. Expected when people buy flat, they say cross ventilation hai ya nahi hai? Do we have cross ventilation or not? Do we have veranda or not? Balcony were there, planter were there, everything was there. So, it came very fashionable to make glass building, other buildings, and you know, balcony enclosed over there, and you know, servant quarters enclosed to that, and floor building enclosed to that. Whole thing became like a workable space. And they found air conditioning and found other things over there. Now we find the shortage of power, shortage of water, and they're talking about too many people, too many mouths to feed over there, and less resources available. Sustainable. Cut down. So sustainable architecture is part of life. It's no great science over there. It's common sense architecture. Fortunately today, a lot of advancement is made by the industry, which is very good. You're getting very high efficient equipments available, energy efficient equipments available, materials available which are also made more efficient, and they consume less power, tiles and flooring material, and choosing wood boards which are made from a waste board over there. Certified materials available which do not consume much power, they do not use too much natural resources. We must have a knowledge, architects must have acquired knowledge of all the new technologies that are now available to use them in your construction, in your building design, whether it is flooring or wood or tiling or roof or equipment for saving energy or insulation. We have to, of course, cut down the power consumption, cut down the water consumption, and collect the water resources, like water harvesting to do that. And the other thing is to have a natural alternate source of energy, the solar lights, solar films are available plenty on now, and you can use in your facade, in your rooftop, solar water heating system over there. How to cut down and generate alternate source of energy? So it will possibly cut down the power which is fuel you use for the power outside in the plant. That my energy will be saved, that my consumption will be saved, that my pollution will be saved. So in time to come, I see that all buildings will be having rooftop solar panels, building facade will be have solar films, the future architecture will be energy efficient, not only energy efficient, energy producing. By building, the future will be producing power. See, old time, we were making our glazing double glazing, you know, so the heat should not penetrate. Very good. They be making a big slogan that, you know, only 90%, 100% light goes over there, only 15 to 20% heat goes inside and 70% heat reflected back into the atmosphere. Great job done. What was happening, the 70% light goes, sunlight, energy reflects back into the atmosphere, into earth over there. Because we have us, we have outside atmosphere, we have pollution, we have particle, dust particle. So this light heat does not escape back into atmosphere, get trapped. And that causes a greenhouse effect. Idea is not to allow the heat to reflect back, to absorb it and convert into power. That's a new technology. That's a new thought. So my solar window glass, possibly, which we're using over there, will allow, trap the heat, convert into power, and save the greenhouse effect. That is the future.